The southeast's new satellite hospitals are causing confusion, with new data revealing hundreds of patients are showing up in need of emergency care. It's added to calls for them to be renamed after a senior health official was caught on tape declaring they are not hospitals.
They're called satellite hospitals, but if your life is in danger, do not come here.
We just don't want people going to the wrong place for the wrong care.
The sign may say hospital, but there's a big difference. The centres do not have emergency beds, nor can they provide emergency life-saving surgeries, unlike hospitals. There's no emergency department that you'd find in a hospital. There is no 24-hour care or overnight stays. Instead, they offer minor care, things such as stitches, broken bones and minor burns.
I think at the end of the day, it's really important to have clarity as to what services are provided.
Free, accessible healthcare in their communities, and that's what our satellite hospitals do.
New health figures released today show 356 patients needing the most serious care have turned up to the southeast's three separate satellite hospitals at Caboolture, Redlands and Ripley, only to be put in an ambulance and sent away. No one is arguing the centres aren't a great initiative, even the opposition.
The LNP is on the record of supporting these facilities.
But many argue calling them hospitals is incorrect. Before they were even built, a senior Queensland health director was caught in secret recordings declaring,
I'm walking a tightrope between when is a hospital, not a hospital. I lobbied for them not to be called satellite hospitals. The satellite hospital program is a political direction and intent.
While the name may cause debate, few can argue that satellite hospitals aren't effective. They're easing the burden on our major hospitals, freeing up doctors and nurses, and they're providing Queenslanders with a more convenient option for non-urgent care.
We've seen almost 15,000 Queenslanders through our satellite hospitals. Less than 0.1% of those patients have been a Category 1, needing urgent care.
Peter Fegan, Nine News.